It's very important to me that when I start a project, I prepare in advance to ensure that it's connected to the curriculum. All of the subjects that are taught in our school can be interlinked. So this interdisciplinary approach is really key. So I get together with my colleagues. We come up with a plan of what haven't we done? What can we do? Maybe what can we do better than we did last year? What project topic would interest our students and how can we integrate this in the subjects that we teach?
For a general high school, combining eTwinning projects with their curriculum, I think that is quite easy. But for us, for vocational schools, we can only combine topics that are not specialized to our school subjects or topics which concern only similar vocational schools.
We have to make clear which are the goals we want to achieve. And the second action is to have a meeting or to have a discussion with all the partners in the project and to try to find which are the goals that we have in common. We have got a project this year in the new platform, which is called PACEM. PACEM means in Latin peace. And in this project, there were classical teachers, teachers of Latin and Greek. There were a teacher of English. In my case, I was then teaching theater. We finally find common goals to work with. For example, communication in languages, in English, but also in classical languages. The use of technology, which is so important in eTwin projects.
This process is dynamic, of course. We made the project plan. The project plan shows the structure of the project, the division of tasks, the responsibilities between the partners. At all times, we have a communication between the partners. This makes the project dynamic.
The fact that most of the activities are made in transnational groups implies that the acquisition of social and personal competencies, for example, teamwork, collaboration, personal development, proper communication. For example, the students have to choose the topic, have to interact in the forums, have to use a lot of digital tools for gamification or to share information, to create a video, a lot of different video editors.
The project began with my students with the creation of a videos presentation of Edison robot. We incorporated mechanical concepts, mechanisms with activities with robotic models. They created videos about an important mechanical element, the gear, Lego gears. And we tried to teach the younger pupils what is a gear. Our students take the role of mentor. So I think that they combined this project with a curriculum from reading, writing, listening, speaking English.
When we're coming up with a new project idea, we always have that in the back of the mind. What can the pupils develop? Of course, we look at the European framework, and this framework gives a really great way for us to focus on specific competencies. Foreign language skills, that's very important, but so is ICT. But what does that mean? That means becoming critical users of all the resources that are available to them on the internet, how to be responsible users. Some of the results I think are really, really great. Digital books, for example. We did one on climate change. So what this means is when you're flipping through the digital book, you'll see pages with the children's drawings, and it specifically says from which transnational team that drawing is, from which country. But then there'll be also an image, a copyright-free image from the internet done by another country, but then there's also the audio in all the various languages explaining what that term means and so forth. The teachers are involved from different subjects, overseeing the copyright issues if there are any, then the art teacher oversees if she's involved, the paintings and the drawings that the children have done, the text is overseen by whatever subject teacher is helping us or is involved in the project, whether it's geography, for example, or the English language teacher.
We always have got a challenge or difficulties to solve. For example, the first one is that we are teachers from different subjects. To solve this situation, we design a good plan with common goals, and it works. Another problem is always that we are different schools with different schedule, different holidays. When we cannot adjust the schedule, I had to ask to some hours to another college or change 1 hour. Another challenge is when the students are of different ages, and this can be solved distributing tasks properly, practicing the peer-to-peer collaboration. Now the eldest one can help the youngest.
My tips for integrating the curriculum into an e-twinning project are definitely to take a good look at what you'll be doing that year in the subject that you teach, and then work with a colleague who is teaching the class that you are, for example. If you want to get just one specific class involved, sit down, talk with your colleague, see what ideas you can come up with, look at the curriculum in detail and see how you can connect the topics that you'll be teaching that year. Find the things that will interest you and your pupils, talk to them. The children always have great ideas about what they want to learn about. Everything and anything can be part of a great project and connect it to the real world outside your classroom.